Last week, the chiral chain model was introduced. We saw that with the choice of the proper parameters, this model supports Majorana fermions at the end of the chain. This model is very special. It's in 1D, it's one-dimensional model. There is only one type of particles, there is only one species of particles. There are no spin flavor. And they pair up somehow to form a superconductor. So in some sense, this model is a half of a conventional superconductor. For me, it is very inspiring, and it was very inspiring to think how about the possibility to build this type of toy model using ingredients that exist in the laboratory, using real systems. This is generally a very interesting and approach to study problems in modern physics. There is a toy model, and you have to think deeply how to create it in the laboratory. And on the way, we learn many things. So initially, it seems hopeless. We know that one-dimensional wires exist in nature. They can be, in principle, be fabricated in the laboratory. But superconductivity is very weak in 1D. And in any case, its pairing is between spin-up and spin-down electrons. So how can we create pairing between spin-up electrons? But thinking about it a bit more, there is a possibility to create an effective model, effectively, this chiral chain model. And this can be done especially if we don't take all the ingredients from the same material, but rather taking two or more different materials, combining their properties together to form the conditions needed for the creation of Kitai's model. So the first ingredient is 1D superconductivity. This can be done by taking a one-dimensional spin-full wire and put it in proximity to a superconductor. Then, through the Andreev reflection, through pair tunneling of electrons with opposite spins to the superconductor, the superconductor gap is induced in the wire. So the wire becomes a superconductor. And now we want to get rid of one of the species, one of the spin flavor. So this can be done by applying very strong a magnetic field. Then we will have only spin-up electrons in the wire. Now, however, we will pay a price, of course, if we have only spin-up electrons in the wires, in the wire. So we cannot induce superconducting gap in the wire. We need spin-up and spin-down to hop from the wire to the superconductor together, a pair of these guys. But there is only spin-up in the wires. So the gap, the induced superconducting gap in the wire disappears when we apply a strong magnetic field. So we need something more, something in addition. We need something that will rotate the spin in the wire. Now, this rotation can be done in the wire or in the transition between the wire to the superconductor or in the superconducting conductor itself. And this something is the spin orbit coupling. So if we have spin orbit coupling, that coupling that rotates the spin of the electrons as they move in a very strong electric field, this will allow to have only one flavor, one species of particles in the wire, and they rotate due to the, let's say, spin-up, they rotate due to the spin-orbit coupling, and then they can hop to the superconductor. So we have one flavor in the wire, but the spin is not a good quantum number anymore. And indeed, so far, all the experiments that observe signature for Majorana fermions were built of one-dimensional system in proximity to a superconductor. So we need superconductivity. And they were heavy material, so they had spin-orbit coupling. And under the we add also the action of magnetic field. So if we have superconductivity, spin-orbit coupling, and magnetic field, we may have, by tuning the parameter correctly, we may have Majorana fermions at the end of the wire.